Now you listen to me real good. I've told you once, I said it 1,000 times. You get out of those pagan, satanic, religious, Christian churches. Christians do not follow the commandments of the Bible. Christians do what they want to do. They make up their own laws, their own rules, and their own regulations. Come out of her, my people, and come out from among them. And it's real simple and easy to ascertain who are these people you need to come out from. Easy. Number one, if they keep Sunday, that's an automatic sign that you need to not have any fellowship with these commandment-breaking, wicked deceivers and seducers and bewitchers of the truth. Simple.
Boy, these spirits, boy, these soft mouths ain't there.
Well, in case...
one thing that Satan does.
Most of you are not familiar.
Because if he can't get you through everybody else, then the last resort is to get you sick.
With that, that's called casting out demons. You know, there's a lot of people say, oh, you can't do that. You can't do it. Been doing it. I don't know how to say, you know, I just don't argue with it. I just do it. And I've been doing it for the last 20 years. So... I mean, the burden of proof is on you now. I mean, there's people, oh, you ain't casting out no demon. Then what is that then? Just people going crazy? Amazing, isn't it? Y'all know the drill. I greet you all, every single one of you that are here listening by way of Blog Talk Radio here tonight. Hallelujah. Be you here or on YouTube. Hallelujah. Streaming, listening. Ah, glory to the King. Hallelujah. Let me get things going. What we got going on here? What we got going on here? I greet you all in the sweet, precious, strong, victorious, and mighty overcoming name of our soon coming King, Yahshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ. And I'm glad that you're here. We're here tonight because we're going to be answering your questions. Hallelujah. And I'm going to go up and do the drill like I normally do. Go check the board. And I'll be right back here in just a moment to entertain your questions. Hallelujah. Just wanted to see how everything is looking, how everything is doing. We're doing pretty good. Bro Shane updated the computer. I noticed I'm sitting pretty low tonight. I don't know why that is. Let me try to adjust this camera a little bit. See how that is. All right, here we go. That's a little too much that way. Look too much that way. All right. Glory to the King. I'll be right back here in just a second. Let you go ahead and hear Sister Wenda give a mailing address. Guest call in number. Guest call in number if you would like to talk to Pastor Dow. It's 515-602-9654. 515-602-9654. Looking forward to hearing from you. If you want to talk to me, hey, now listen, tonight, get straight to the point. Don't come on here and give us a five-hour message or a five-minute message. Just get straight to the point because we got a lot we got to cover. And I got to actually get off a little bit early tonight because I've got an extraordinary large message tomorrow, okay? So we're here, Sister Wenda here, just for a moment. Give a ministry break for those of you who want to support us. We appreciate it. I'll be right back here in just a second.
Shalom, this is Sister Wenda. I hope that all of you are enjoying the broadcast that you're listening to right now. We appreciate each and every last one of you, our faithful listeners and supporters of the Straight Way Truth radio broadcast. We try to make sure that we do our due diligence and do our best to ensure that you have the best broadcast as well as the truth coming to you in the hour that we're living in right now. If you would like to help us in this endeavor, your offering will be greatly appreciated in the work of the Ministry of the Most High Yah. Our mailing address for your gift, offering, or letter of support is Charles Dowell, Jr. That's Charles Dowell Jr., and Dowell is spelled D-O-W-E-L-L. 506 Ellington Drive. Ellington is spelled E-L-L-I-N-G-T-O-N. P.O. Box 32, Lafayette, Tennessee. And Lafayette is spelled L-A-F-A-Y-E-T-T-E. 37083. Again, our mailing address is Charles Dowell Jr., 506 Ellington Drive, P.O. Box 32, Lafayette, Tennessee, 37083. If you would like to contact us by way of phone, the country code is 1, area code 615-883025. That's 1-615-688-3025. You may leave a message there, and be the Father's will, we will do whatever we can to try to return your message. It is our hope and our prayer that as you continue to listen to the Straightway Truth Ministry, and as you apply the teachings of this ministry, that you are finding peace and growth within you, your family, and life as well. Please tell others so that the truth may also have an impact and touch others' lives, so that they may enjoy the benefits of the truth of Jesus Christ, just like we all are. Shalom, the King is coming.
Hallelujah, shalom, the King is coming. All right. All right, again, guest call-in number right behind me, 515-602-9654. You like to talk to Pastor Dow? You call in, press number one. After you call in, when you hear the lady, the computer voice, and then I'll be able to entertain your question. We'll see a little shield with a question mark up there. Hallelujah. All right. We're going to go to Arizona. Call number 928. I usually call the area code sometime the first three digits. And that's about it. Hallelujah. 928-928-970. Arizona, Brother Matt. This is Pastor Dow. You are on the Straightway Truth Radio broadcast. How can I help you, Brother Matt?
Shabbat shalom, Pastor Dow.
Shabbat shalom, Brother Matt.
So I have a question. So I got a promotion at work, and I got another one coming, but in order to get it, I have to go to class, and it falls on the Sabbath, Friday and Saturday. Is that okay to go to that? I mean,
where are you at? Are you in the military or something?
I'm in Payson, Arizona, but the class is in Pine Top.
In what?
The class is going to be in Pine Top, Arizona, but it's going to be held on the Sabbath. It's for Friday and Saturday. And I was just wondering if, is that breaking the Sabbath by going to class?
I can only tell you what I would do. I wouldn't go. That's me personally. I wouldn't go. I can't tell you what you should do. Are you following me?
Yes, sir.
Does that make sense?
And then, another question, how do I get one of them shirts that you're wearing?
Well, we have not yet even made these shirts yet available, just yet, because I'm talking to the people, but just the price of this shirt, just this shirt alone, my cost is like, what is it, $30-something. You can see it, I'll get up close on the camera there. You can see that it's got embroidery, and it's high quality embroidery. But we're going to be making them available soon, right now. Have you ever seen these before? You ever seen these before?
No, I haven't.
Man, that's the hoodie. It's a very thick hoodie. It's almost as thick as a coat. And people be wearing them. But just stay tuned. And we're going to make some of these shirts available here in the near in the near future. Because I first got to get a demand, that people would like to have these shirts. Because I mean, if I'm going to get a demand and people going to commit to it, I would hate to go and fork over a whole bunch of money and then the shirts are just sitting in my home, in my storage room, if you know what I mean.
But
how's the weather out there, man? Are y'all getting sprayed by them chemtrails like we are?
Well, it's been getting some rain tonight and tomorrow, you know, but the weather's been pretty nice here in Payson.
What about the chemtrails? Did you see my video with the chemical trails?
Oh, I haven't.
Oh, man, it's only about a minute long, but, man, they've been hammering us with them chemtrails up here.
Oh, wow. I'm sure we get it up here. I just, you know, we're up in the mountains, so it's not too bad. We're not in the city.
All right. Hey, you stay tuned and stay posted. I'll be more than happy to get you one of these shirts as soon as we make them available, okay?
Okay, for sure. And then I called, you sent me an email and a number, and I called and left a message, and I talked to one of the sisters, because you said you were going to have one of the saints or their brothers call me and, you know, discuss, you know, being part of the straightway. So I don't know. I never heard back from anybody yet. You know, I've talked to Brother John, you know, in Phoenix, and you know, really nice guy and stuff.
When did you call and leave the message?
On the same day I got the email. I think it was about, I think it was either Monday or Tuesday.
Well, Elder Doug usually gets back with people right here. We'll check on it, okay?
All right, thank you, sir.
All right. Bless you, Brother Matt.
All right, Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom. Let's go to Georgia Junior, 929-251. This is Pastor Dow, you on the Straight Ritual Radio broadcast. How can I help you there, Brother Junior?
Shabbat Shalom, Pastor.
Shabbat Shalom, Junior.
Shabbat Shalom, Pastor. Yes, sir. That video deal for me yesterday, that was a beautiful video, Pastor.
Which one?
That committee one, the 20 May one, the 30th anniversary. That was a beautiful one.
Well, I'm trying to give people the skinny, if you understand what I mean. Most people, I know some people are just not cut out to be leaders in the community.
I understand. They think they are, but they too powerful, you know. It takes sacrifice to get a community, you know. You gotta change your mind. Yes, sir. And, you know, like the last 2 days, you know, I've been clear here, sunny. No chemtrails here.
All right.
But they asked, yes, sir. So, you keep on doing your videos and, you know, just keep bringing. So, I don't have much. Bless you, Pastor. Love you so much. Shalom, sir.
Bless you, Brother Junior. It's about Shalom. You know, Passover is coming up, and if you would like to attend Passover, you need to make yourself known. Passover is coming up, and I think it's going to be on April 10th. If you're coming, we need to know, and we need to know fast, because logistically, we have to prepare for you. All right? We have to prepare for you. All right, so let us know. Glory to the King. Let's go to New York. Call number 646-730. This is Pastor Dow. You're on the Straight Ritual Radio broadcast. I can help you.
Shabbat Shalom, Pastor Dow. How are you, sir?
Doing well. Who am I talking with?
Brother Israel.
Brother Israel, okay. How you doing, Brother Israel?
Very well, very well. Enjoying my Shabbat, getting the rest in, as they say. Getting much rest needed.
All right, how can I help you?
Well, my question is a two-parter, actually. It's on two different fronts. My first question is, you had touched a few months back regarding cutting the silver cord when you see a manifestation of a spirit in a room, and how to, if you can, get into that briefly, or where can I find that information regarding that. And my other part of the question, my secondary question is it okay to use a microwave during the Shabbat?
Again, I can tell you what I do. Number one, we don't even have a microwave on the community. We don't use microwaves. Is that making sense?
Yes, sir.
We don't use microwaves because you're killing all the nutritional value of that food as soon as you cut that thing on. So we don't even use microwaves.
Yes, sir.
All right. What's your next question?
All right. My first part of the question was regarding the cutting of the silver cord. You had touched upon that a few months back, and I didn't see any follow-up video or where can I find information regarding that.
You go to demonbusters.com. They got some. I'm sure we have some on straightway.com as well. But the cutting of the silver cord, you know, that's something you'll find definitely, you'll find it mentioned actually in the scripture. It's mentioned in there. Go to Ecclesiastes 12:6.
Ecclesiastes 12:6.
Hold on. Let me get my Bible. Let me cut this thing. Let me see. Ecclesiastes. Hold on a second. Where is it?
Yes, sir.
All right. Hold on. All right. Ecclesiastes 12:6. Or ever the silver cord be loosed, or the golden bowl be broken, or the pitcher be broken at the fountain, or the wheel be broken at the cistern. What we've learned about the silver cord is that we've learned because witches and stuff, you know, they astral project. And we notice that spiritually there is a lot of things that natural people don't understand, but there's a cord that actually connects the spirit to the body. And when you cut that cord, that makes sure that these people don't get back in their body. They got the audacity to try to astral project and show themselves up in the room. And I know that a lot of spiritual warfare stuff sounds over the top to a lot of people because, remember, if you haven't experienced, it can't be true. If you haven't done it, can't be true. On the other thing, I'm answering questions vaguely because if people listen to me up front, they should have known a lot of these things. Now, we warm food in a toaster oven or something like that, but we don't use microwaves and we don't go out and start fires on the Sabbath. We just don't do that, but we do warm them in a toaster oven, all right?
Yes, sir. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Shabbat shalom.
Good night. Shabbat shalom.
Let's go to Brother Peter. Call number 727-267. This is Pastor Dow, Inner Circuit 2 Radio Broadcast. I can help Brother Peter.
Hallelujah. Shabbat shalom, Pastor.
Shabbat shalom. You get my letter, Peter?
Yes, sir.
All right. Glory to the King.
I did.
Got yours too. Thank you, brother.
Hallelujah. Yes, sir. Glory to the King. I just have one thing I have to say. It's really good to hear your voice, sir, and I thank you for your commitment to the Most High and giving us the word. Hallelujah. Two questions, actually.
Okay.
One question is that since the world, you know, they run mail during the Shabbat,
yep.
Is it lawful to send tithes before the seventh day and then have it shipped to you on Shabbat? Is that lawful?
Sure it is, because and notice the Sabbath has to do with regulations within your gates. It has nothing to do with the heathen. The heathen is not even bound by these laws.
Okay. Hallelujah. Yes, sir. Okay. The second question is that lately, since I moved to Louisiana, I've been feeling a lot of, it feels like in my hands and my feet, something is being written on my hands and my feet. Is there any way I can break that in Jesus' name?
Well, you just break any curses that you deserve. I mean, one thing you need to do, and everybody out there, you know, Jesus is real.
Yeah.
And if you have a personal relationship with him, you have to slow down your mind enough to be able to hear that still, small voice. Because you got the ruach, that voice is there. I promise he is. And but a lot of times, man, you just have to break a lot of these curses. Louisiana is a wicked state anyway. I mean, all the states in the Union are wicked.
It is.
But that state is, man, is full of witchcraft,
yes,
man.
I agree. Hallelujah. Yeah. It is wicked. It's wicked out here. It really is. And it's a warfare every day. box, especially by myself, but I think, yeah, though, hallelujah. Okay, thank you, Pastor, for all you do, and looking forward to hearing the message tomorrow.
All right, bless you, Brother Peter. Shabbat shalom. Most of you don't know our messages. Our messages is at www.online. That's like online-church-church.org. We're there at 11 a.m. Central Standard Time every Shabbat. Every Shabbat we're there, 11 a.m. Central Standard Time. I may even talk to brother and say, you know what? We may try it now that we got a brand new computer and stuff. We'll do a test run. Brother Saint, see about broadcasting on YouTube tomorrow live. Now listen to me, Saints. If we broadcast on YouTube live tomorrow and we start experiencing a lot of hiccups and stuff, we're going to shut down the broadcast on YouTube and immediately return to online-church.org, okay? So what we're going to do is run a test to see if we can actually broadcast live on YouTube tomorrow, okay? All right? So everybody get that word passed around, okay? So don't think we're not going to be there. Just get the word, text message, Facebook, do whatever you got, all right? And we're going to see if we can get the message out to the people. We're going to do a test run because we've been upgrading our equipment. And actually, you should see me clear. As a matter of fact, do you see me clear on this camera than what you have previously viewed me? If you have, I mean, just say yes or no. And if the clarity has improved, just let me know. Just, you know, type something short up there in the chat room. And what we'll do is I'll take a phone call, then I'll go up and take another break, and then we'll get back to your phone calls, and I'll go check the messages, all right? All right, glory to the King. Back to Louisiana, call number 318-318-416. This is Pastor Dow. You're on the Shirt with You radio broadcast. How can I help you?
How you doing, Pastor Dow? This is Terry Ann calling from Louisiana.
Terry Ann?
I just had a question. Terry Ann.
Okay, how you doing?
I'm all right. I'd first like to say thanks for taking my call. My wife is pregnant, and she usually has to take the Rogaine shot for her body kind of expels the baby. I was wondering, do you think it's safe that she gets the shot again, or should we try going without it?
I don't. What kind of shot is that? What's the purpose of it, and what does it do?
The Rogaine shot is supposed to help her carry the child because she has Rh negative blood. So if she don't have this shot, her body kind of kills the kid.
Ooh. Man, it kind of makes me wonder about your diet. First of all, you know, I'm a pastor, not a medical doctor, and I can't give you information and stuff like that. But if I was you, I would go ahead and continue to have my wife to take the shot.
Okay.
So that you don't lose the baby.
Okay. All right. I just wanted to. I'm just trying to get all the way down to living my life towards the Bible.
Oh yeah. Well, it takes a little time because remember, Rome wasn't built in a day. But you know, you have to get educated. A lot of times, people when they start off becoming an Israelite, because they discover who they are, there's a lot of things we like to. Some things we can change immediately. Other thing is going to take a process of time. I'll give you an example. Right now, I'm not with you, but you know, I'm sure that your diet is nowhere near the way that it should be. And so you've got to educate yourself on the scriptures to see what the word says, and you've got to educate yourself in growing food. You know, it's a steep learning curve. And as you do that, you'll get perfected and you'll grow, and then chances are if your wife ever gets pregnant again, you probably won't need those shots. Is that making sense?
Yes, sir. It made perfect sense.
So don't run too fast that you end up running out of breath, but just stay consistency. Remember, the Most High said I would rather that you are either hot or cold, but because you're lukewarm, he's going to spew you out of his mouth. So just keep running steady. You all right, my brother?
Yes, sir. I have one more question for you.
Go ahead.
Would you think that it'll be a great idea to have the baby in the hospital or a home birth?
I mean, do you have a midwife?
No, it will be like, no, we don't have one of those. I just.
How old are you?
So much conspiracy. I'm 27.
I don't know, brother. I mean, see, we have all our babies at home. Very rarely, on rare occasions, that we have to actually recommend that someone go to the hospital, and that's a very rare occasion. But we usually birth ours in homes and stuff, and again, that's another area. You know, if you're not comfortable with it, you need to go ahead and go to the hospital because, I mean, people have babies at home as well as in the hospital. You're just going to save a lot more money if you do it at home if you know what you're doing. You understand what I mean? So these choices and decisions, these things you got to grow into.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you very much, Les.
You're welcome. Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom. Shabbat shalom.
All right. I'll tell you what, Saints, I'll be right back here in just a second. I'm going to go check the board, and we're going to hear from our famous Sister Wenda again with the mailing address. All right. Be right back.
Shalom. This is Sister Wenda. I hope that all of you are enjoying the broadcast that you're listening to right now. We appreciate each and every last one of you, our faithful listeners and supporters of the Straight Way Truth radio broadcast. We try to make sure that we do our due diligence and do our best to ensure that you have the best broadcast as well as the truth coming to you in the hour that we're living in right now. If you would like to help us in this endeavor, your offering will be greatly appreciated in the work of the Ministry of the Most High Yah. Our mailing address for your gift, offering, or letter of support is Charles Dowell Jr. That's Charles Dowell Jr. And Dowell is spelled D-O-W-E-L-L. 506 Ellington Drive. Ellington is spelled E-L-L-I-N-G-T-O-N. P.O. Box 32, Lafayette, Tennessee. And Lafayette is spelled L-A-F-A-Y-E-T-T-E 37083. Again, our mailing address is Charles Dowell Jr., 506 Ellington Drive, P.O. Box 32, Lafayette, Tennessee 37083. If you would like to contact us by way of phone, the country code is 1, area code 615-688-3025. That's 1-615-688-3025. You may leave a message there, and be the Father's will, we will do whatever we can to try to return your message. It is our hope and our prayer that as you continue to listen to the Straightway Truth Ministry, and as you apply the teachings of this ministry, that you are finding peace and growth within you, your family, and life as well. Please tell others so that the truth may also have an impact and touch others' lives so that they may enjoy the benefits of the truth of Jesus Christ just like we all are. Shalom, the King is coming.
All right. Shalom, shalom, shalom. King is coming. All right. We're right back. We're back. We're back. All right. Let's go ahead and continue on here. All right. Louisiana, call number 318-318-955. Pastor Dowell, you on the Straight Way Truth Radio broadcast. How can I help you?
Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.
My name is Tyron. I'm just calling to make myself known.
All right. How you doing, Tyron?
All right. It's been a while.
How long you been listening to me?
Almost 3 years.
3 years. All right, you're making yourself known. All right, what you got, my brother?
Nothing much. I'm just trying to make myself known.
All right. Hallelujah. Well, glad that you're listening. Glad that you're on board.
Yes, sir. That's all.
All right, brother. Bless you. Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.
All right, let's go to Virginia. Brother Chris, call number 571-533. 571-533 is Pastor Dow. You're on the Straight Way Truth Radio broadcast. I can help you.
Shabbat shalom, Pastor.
Hey, how you doing, Brother Chris?
I'm fine. Thank you. I wanted to thank you for the invitation and all I need to do to pass over. And I had two quick questions.
All right, let's go with it. What you got?
If say a bucket got defiled because of some particular reason, would it be sufficient to just hose it down? Is there like a method to getting it clean again, since I can't really put it in water?
If a bucket got defiled for some particular reason, what do you mean a bucket getting defiled?
Touching it with unclean hands.
With unclean hands?
Yes, sir.
What do you mean by touching a bucket with unclean hands, brother?
Because I work in kind of goes into very deep, because I work in a place where I have to touch certain things, and sometimes it leaks on me, and I just get defiled by that point, and I don't really bother with touching or washing my clothes, work clothes. So I just wear them throughout the week, and I just continually clean myself. But I have no choice but to touch certain things because I have to walk through doors and touch things. So sometimes I have to move things and touch my buckets. So in a way, I'm asking, how can I re-clean it?
I guess it all depends on what these buckets are used for.
Oh, food storage.
Food stores, touching buckets, food store. Brother, you got me on that one. That was a very spiritual question, but man, I tell you, if you have a conviction over buckets or something like that, or you know what's going on, and you think within yourself that there's something wrong with touching these buckets, or you have a concern, then I would clean myself, and I would go out and buy some new buckets just for conscience sake, just so I wouldn't have to worry about if my conscience is condemning me over some buckets and touching them.
Oh, boy. Thank you, sir.
Does that make sense?
I also wanted to... Yes, sir. But thank you also for posting that video about the Tennessee song.
Oh, yeah, you're welcome. Elder Root said it wasn't up. It's still on, but I remember that song. I think it came out in 1992. Did you read the lyrics to that song?
No, sir, but it immediately just, it got to me. And I really, really enjoyed it.
Hey, I got the lyrics posted on the video. You go down there in the information section, you read the lyrics.
Yes, sir.
All right, my brother.
Okay.
Shabbat shalom.
Thank you. Shabbat shalom, sir.
Shabbat shalom. We just left Virginia. Let's go to Connecticut. Call number 203 there in Connecticut. This is Pastor Dow, you on the Shirt Rich Youth Radio broadcast. I can help you there in Connecticut.
Hi, can you hear me?
I can hear you loud and clear.
Hey, Pastor Dow. Alright, so this is my question.
Alright.
Me and my woman were having a baby. She's in the medical field.
Oh, wait a minute.
Our family is in the medical field.
Wait a minute, you and your woman, you and your ishi, you and your wife, you and your what do you mean?
Me and my wife.
Okay. You and your wife are having a what? A baby.
Yeah.
All right, go ahead.
Yeah, and she's in the medical field. Her entire family, they've made a career out of it. You know, I woke up to the New World Order when I was 19. I'm 27. I tried showing her these things. She's kind of, she's got a wall up against it. We just found out we're having the baby 2 days ago, and I'm trying to tell her about the danger of vaccines, and she's not hearing it. What information can I show her to wake her up, because I'm freaked out about this, man. I want to have a healthy baby.
Brother, you know, we live in captivity. You're in a rock and a hard place, because they give so much strength and so much power to a woman. And more than likely, you came to the faith after you got married to her. Is that correct?
Yeah.
And that's what makes it difficult when you only got one person serving the Father and the other one isn't. I guess what you do, man, is just continually go to the internet and download facts about vaccines, and preferably get it from someone from a medical profession, and just put it in her face. Just leave it somewhere that she can actually read it for herself. Don't cram it down her throat. Just leave it in a place you know that she's going to visit, and let her read it and let her get educated. She chooses not to read it, brother. I tell you, that's the reason why I say, you know, we're in a rock and a hard place, man. We married to these people that have Gentile mindsets, but hey, maybe you, by your lifestyle, can gain her.
Okay. All right, that's all I had to ask.
But man, you rise up on this one, man. Next thing you know, man, this system is powerful, standing for the women.
Yeah, and I kind of have her whole family against me right now. I am in between a rock and a hard place.
Yeah, that's going to happen anyway, man, because don't feel bad. My I ain't got no family that's getting me because all my family is in the faith. So I don't have no natural family anyway. Because they can't serve my God. I guess I don't need them, and they definitely made sure that they don't need me. So, hey, I'm fine.
Okay. Can you say a prayer for me?
Yeah. Hallelujah. I'll pray for you. Will. Sure will, my brother, because you're going to need it. We'll pray that y'all turn that wife's heart.
Thank you.
All right, my brother. Shabbat Shalom.
All right, Pastor. You have a good night.
You know, a lot of people say that they love their children. And I always say that people don't love children. If you don't love your children enough, let me give you, for instance, if you're married and you're getting ready to have children, and you say you love your husband, you love your wife, you're supposed to have the type of environment to where you actually communicate with each other. You have an exchange, a flow of information with each other. And in that communication, you know, you're supposed to be rational. Both of you are, especially if you're at two different ends of the spectrum concerning faith. And you should be able to, you know, reason together. But man, I tell you, man, a lot of these women, they so unreasonable. Hey, I don't blame MGTOW. MGTOW is getting bigger and bigger. And more women are going to find themselves without men. And that's the reason why we see this lesbian and homosexual spirit rising today, because no men even want none of these women. These women today that refuse to fear Yah, read the Bible, and refuse to serve Him, man, they more or less monsters. That's what they pretty much gender to. But it's a sad thing when you have a marriage and you can't even listen to each other. It's just a sad, sad situation. That's what that is. All right, let's go to New York. Call number 917-917. This is Pastor Dow. You're on the Strip Ritual Radio broadcast. I can help you there in New York. Going on once.
Hello?
Shalom.
Hello? Oh, shalom. Hello. I'm just making myself known. And I also wanted to thank you for your wisdom and your knowledge that you give every Shabbat and in your video.
What is your name, sister?
Oh, I'm sorry. Capricia?
Precia?
Capricia.
Oh, Capricia.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
All right. How old are you, Capricia, if you don't mind me asking?
I'm 17.
17. Wow. Man, I tell you, the Most High has got you listening at a very early age, don't he?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I'm very thankful.
Well, hallelujah. It's good good to hear you. Good to have you. Thank you for your comments.
Yes, thank you for your wisdom. I also have a question.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. Go ahead.
I told my mom about, you know, me watching you and everything, and, you know, the change of dress and the reason, thing and everything. She's completely supportive and already asked her, so I guess the only thing left is to ask you, may I attend Passover?
Sure, if you can get the permission from your parents to attend Passover, then you can come. Are you with a fellowship up there?
No, sir. Oh, okay, so right now I'm calling from, like, Google. I didn't know you could do that. And it's, like, showing that I'm from New York, which I'm not. I'm from North Carolina.
You're from where?
North Carolina.
North Carolina, okay.
Yes, sir. I already called the dining hall and I made myself known. I talked to Sister Ashley.
Will your parents? Will your parents let you travel here for Passover?
Yes, sir.
How are you going to get up here? You going to drive or you going to fly or what?
I'm not sure. I assume drive, but I'm not sure. We haven't talked about the details, but she said I could go and she would try to make a way for me to go.
Okay. If you fly, we'll have some sisters to pick you up at the airport, okay?
Yes, sir.
Now, we're going to be staying in tents for a couple of days. Are you okay with that?
Yes, sir.
I don't expect for you to have your own gear or nothing like that. We'll furnish you with a tent and some cots and stuff like that so you'll be able to sleep. We may even have you in a tent with another faithful Israelite sister so you have some people to fellowship with, all right?
Thank you. Yes, sir.
Well, you keep me posted on your status, okay?
I will. Thank you.
All right. Hey, make sure. Uh-huh. All right, make sure you get a message, a note from your mother stating that you can attend Passover, okay?
Yes, sir.
All right. Bless you. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat.
All right. Let's go to Minnesota. Brother David, 763-763. It's Pastor Dow. You're on the Straight with You radio broadcast. I can help you there, Brother David.
Shabbat Shalom, Pastor. Am I coming in clear?
Man, you coming in loud and clear, my brother. Loud and clear. I can help you.
Hallelujah. Well, bless you, Pastor. Just here with the fam. Brother Jordan's here and sister and the little one. We just wanted to call and say Shabbat Shalom to you. We don't have too much for you. I know you got a busy board there full of people calling you and asking you for questions. So I just want to say Shabbat Shalom, sir. And I'm pass the phone to Brother Jordan.
Shabbat Shalom, Pastor.
Hey, Shabbat Shalom, Brother Jordan. How you doing?
I'm doing very well, sir. I'm blessed. How are yourself?
Doing well, doing well. How can I help you?
I don't have any questions either, Pastor. I just wanted to call and say blessings and shalom to you and bless Teacher Shane and Elder Becker for their messages this past week. And I'm really looking forward to this next Shabbat. I hope that it's going to be a real long one like you were talking about. I always like ones real long, Pastor.
Man, that was anointed. Man, we had a little bit of anointing going there last Shabbat, didn't we?
Yes, sir. Teacher Shane's passion was something else.
Hallelujah. All right, my brother.
All right, Pastor. Well, bless you and Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom. Bless you, Sister Evelyn.
Shabbat Shalom, sir.
Bless you. How you doing, daughter? How are you and the baby doing?
We're doing great, sir. Blessed and highly favored.
Hallelujah.
How is Mother Carol? Sir?
I said hallelujah. Glory to the King.
Hallelujah. Is Mother Carol doing great?
Yep. Sure is. Doing fine.
Hallelujah. Well, that's all I have, Pastor. Hope everything is well with you all saints down in Tennessee, and I look forward to the message tomorrow.
All right. Bless you, my sister. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom, Pastor. Bless.
Shabbat Shalom. All right, Brother David. Shabbat Shalom. Bless you. Let's go to Utah, to Sister Lala, call number 801-801. It's Pastor Dow, you on the Straight With You radio broadcast. How can I help you, sister?
Shabbat Shalom, Pastor Dow. How are you?
Doing well. Doing well. How are you?
I'm doing well. I just wanted to call in to say shalom and to give you a brief update about my mom.
Yeah, I heard she passed away, huh?
Last Wednesday. Yeah, it was this past Wednesday. And I actually wanted to say thank you to all of Israel and all the saints that reached out to me and prayed and said nice things and to keep me encouraged during this time.
Yeah. How y'all doing?
We're actually doing good. I think the best way I can describe it is, you know, when David got caught with Bathsheba, when she got pregnant, how the Lord told him that he was going to kill the baby, how he mourned while the baby was alive, and then when the baby finally died, he stopped crying, or he didn't cry at all. It's kind of like that, like I got all that out and came to terms with it before it happened, and now that it's finally come to pass, I was prepared. So, and then the things that you told me also to prepare me for that time helped as well.
Well, hallelujah.
Yeah, I'm very comforted and thankful that I'm at least in the truth, and I have the truth while I'm here alive on earth, and it's just a testimony.
That's true. Hallelujah. Glory to the King.
It's that. Right. Well, I thank you, Pastor. Did you get my letter in the mail also?
Yep, sure did. Got it.
Hallelujah. Well, thank you, Pastor. That's all I have to say. I just wanted to say Shabbat Shalom and thank Israel for all their prayers.
All right, sister. Bless you. Shabbat Shalom.
Bless you.
Hey, by the way, if y'all send a letter to me, and if you really would like a quick response from me, include your email address in the letter, and that way I can respond to you promptly. I'm getting pretty good about responding to the letter. Sometimes it takes a little while, but I do respond to them, and I do answer your questions, and I usually write a letter right back and answer, because, you know, that daggone post office, man, went up another 2 cents on postage. Can y'all believe that? Everybody got their hand out, man, and want every nickel and dime that we making out here today. Unbelievable. Let's go to Tennessee. Call number 901-901. It's Pastor Dow. You're on the Straight Bitchin' Radio broadcast. How can I help you?
Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
Hey, this is Brother Ron from Memphis, Tennessee. It's just me and my wife up right now. The children are already asleep. We just wanted to call and thank you for everything you've been doing. And, you know, that's but I'm gonna give her the phone because she wanted to talk also.
All right. Bless you.
Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom, sister.
All right, that's all. We didn't want to hold you up very long, Pastor Dow. We'll talk to you again soon.
All right, good hearing your voice. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
All right, let's go to California. Call number 562-562. This is Pastor Dow. You're on the Straight Ray 2 Radio broadcast. I can help you.
Shabbat Shalom, Pastor Dow.
Hey, Brother Antoine. How you doing, Brother Antoine? Shabbat Shalom. I can help you, sir.
I'm doing fine. If you would, like, give me some key points and advice when you conduct a spiritual warfare and deliverance, what are some things you would advise somebody? Like, what are the key points?
Well, the main thing is spiritual warfare is about people meeting y'all's conditions. You know, a lot of people want deliverance about a lot of things, but a lot of people don't go about it the right way. You have to.
Right.
And anyone who is getting delivered, you have to meet his conditions. You got to meet his conditions in repentance. You have to meet his conditions no matter what it is. If you have unforgiveness in your heart against someone, you've got to get clear of that. You got to get it right with whoever you got it with and stuff. And when you remove all these grounds, we call them legal grounds that you've given place to the enemy through transgression, sin, iniquity, or whatever. When you meet y'all's conditions, then more than likely you'll get some deliverance pretty fast. And then so it depends on what the war is.
Right. And that was my follow-up question was, is it like, say you feel with the Ruach, you praying for somebody, and you, like, is it possible, like, you could be casting demons out of somebody but not, like, fully delivering them? Like, you just kind of, like, you help them, you know what I'm saying? Like, you cast out some demons, but you know that they're not all the way there. And I'm just trying to figure this out. Like, because, you know, I pray for some people, I see stuff, I see stuff happening, then at the same time, it's like, okay, why does nothing happen to this person? Or why does nothing happen in this situation? And I'm praying for this. Like, but it's you enlightened me, and it's helping me understand that some people got to meet y'all's condition. And witchcraft. I know witchcraft is real because I done met a real witch before I was in high school. She showed me this big, giant book, and I was trying to convince her that she shouldn't be dealing with those spirits. But with witchcraft, how... effective could a witch be if she's like fasting, praying against you, or just sending curses your way? And can people be conducting their witchcraft and not even know it? Like, can they just be so wicked that they don't even know that they're a witch?
Well, sure, you got a bunch of questions going on right there, and I'll try to remember to answer them. Well, first of all, you don't pray for somebody when you're doing deliverance. You are actually following the command of Yah by casting them out. That's what Jesus said. You're commanding by authority, okay, casting them out. And then number two, concerning witches, you know, hey, if anybody says anything negative or derogatory about you, they're pronouncing a curse upon you. And what you have to do is become proactive and send those curses back every single day in Jesus' name, because you don't never know. Hey, the curse calls it shall not come. And you don't never know what people are doing and stuff. If I was a witch, and if they want to, you know, do that, you can turn them spirits right back on them, and them spirits would end up attacking those witches.
Right. Because I think one time somebody did say, can I pray for you? It was a random lady online. She said, can I pray for you? And then I was like, yeah, you can pray for me. And she asked me another message, what should I pray for? And I just gave her a basic prayer. It's like, more power in y'all. And then she messaged me back that, like, she was sick. Like, after she prayed for me, she's like, oh, I got sick after I prayed for you. And I'm like, okay, well, all right. I had nothing to do with me. I'm thinking that maybe, because witches, I'll be thinking like some of these people be witches, like they be acting like Christians, or they be acting like spiritual people. They're like, oh, let me pray for you, and then try to put curses on you.
All right, my brother.
But yeah, that's basically I wanted to touch on this spiritual warfare and deliverance. And you answered the question.
All right, well, bless you, my brother.
All right, bless you, Pat.
Shabbat shalom. Let's go to Georgia, Sister Shekinah. This is Pastor Dial 404-404. How can I help you?
Good evening, my pastor.
Good morning. I mean, good evening. Good evening. How are you doing?
I'm all right, Pastor. How you been?
I've been working my rear end off.
Yes, sir. I've been seeing your videos. Rapid fire, sir. I really only have one question. It was about an experience, and I was just wondering if you could give me some spiritual insight as to what it may mean, or if it means anything at all.
All right, let's hear it. Maybe I can, maybe I can't.
Yes, sir. It was 1998. I was under the age of 16. I'm not too sure the exact age, and I walked. My grandmother had passed away. We were in the church. And I don't know what it's called when everybody can come up and, like, see the body in the casket at that time. And I was walking to see her, and I got to the last set of pews right before the casket. And as I was trying to walk, it felt like there was a wall there. Like, I could not move any closer to her to see her. And I was wondering, because I remember the story about the donkey, where the angel was standing in the path to prevent the donkey from going further. I was wondering, was that maybe some sort of sign, like maybe to keep me from defiling myself with a dead body, not knowing that, or maybe fear, or I don't know.
Well, I don't know. A lot of people, they like, you know, when they read the Bible, they talk about not being defiled by a dead body and stuff, but when you go back and read that account, it had to do with priests. But I don't know exactly what was going on, because I don't know too much about you and your life at that particular time in order to give you an answer what was going on. I it's hard for me to discern.
Okay. Yes, sir. Understood. Other than that, I just want to say Shabbat Shalom. Ready for the message tomorrow. Excited, actually. And you get some rest if you can.
All right. Bless you. Shabbat Shalom.
Bless you. Yes, sir.
All right. We're going to go to, where are we at? All right. Ohio. Brother Mike, 614-614 is Pastor Dow. You're on the Straight Way Truth Radio broadcast. I can help you.
Shabbat Shalom, Pastor.
Hey, Brother Mike. Shabbat Shalom. How you doing, sir?
I'm well. Thank you for taking my call. Originally, I called in so that I could just kind of shed some light on one thing that we didn't realize we were doing wrong. And I was using a boar's brush. Like, it has boar hair in it. And we didn't realize it, because I don't want to have hair. But, you know, my son does. And, you know, it was a brush that I had been using before, and we didn't think much about it. So my wife had mentioned to me about washing it. And instantly I thought about it, and I thought a lot of other brothers may not have realized it themselves, but that was just something that it came to me. The other thing was, you know, one of the brothers called in talking about, and then y'all made mention about things that they may be eating that was unclaimed, and so that's another thing that made me think about it. The last thing is that recently we've had some opposition from family members, you know, talking about, you know, being in a cult and talking about different things. And even tonight we had a police officer, we had a neighbor show up to my door asking me if everything was fine, because the police officer had questioned him about the welfare of, you know, my family member, per my wife's family, or through my wife's family. So trying to figure out, I guess, if everything's okay. And so it's amazing. I know it's only y'all having us listening today, because somebody just called in a little bit ago about the silver cord, and you told them about anytime somebody said something negative about you to send that curse back. Well, one of the sisters reached out to my wife, and she, you know, told her the very same thing that you just said, and confirmed it, and that's exactly what we did before the broadcast even started. We sent those curses back. So I just wanted to give glory to the Father for that, and then for sending a witness. And it's just amazing how it's a lot of things that are, coming from nowhere. It's like rising up, but, you know, we praise God, because he's given us the power to defeat every single last thing so far. Even things with my wife having stomach issues, and I would just lay hands on her, and the Father would move through it. He would move through the situation and healing. And the other yesterday, my daughter said she wasn't feeling well, and we prayed, and then we commanded those demons and those devils to leave, the spirit of infirmity to leave, and she began to throw up. She threw up for maybe 10 minutes. Every time I said, come out, come out, come out, the demons were leaving her through her vomit. So we cleaned up and everything, and she hasn't had any issues with that since. But it's just been, the spiritual warfare is real right now. Like, everything is so real right now. Since we've been back from getting the baptism of the Holy Spirit, things have been so real right now. But we have some amazing brothers and sisters that are keeping us kind of squared away. So we just thank y'all for that.
Well, hallelujah. I tell you what, my brother. Remember Jesus said, don't cast your pearls before swine, and don't give that which is holy unto dogs. Because these family members, man, they gonna turn and rent you. Is it not remarkable and amazing that your family members can go to any church that they want to, and y'all don't care? You don't care what they do, but all of a sudden you decide to go to any assembly you want. All of a sudden the police is involved, the Department of Child Services involved. People are concerned about stuff that they have no reason to be concerned. So much for freedom of religion in this damn hypocritical ass country.
That's how it goes, Pastor.
Man, I don't let my right hand or left. Don't let your right hand know what your left hand doing, man. Don't let none know what they're doing. And even if they even inquire, man, just point themselves to the ministry, and then let's see how they do.
Yeah, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
These family members off the chain, brother.
I hear that. I see now. Well, they knew that, they knew what we believed, and so they based that off of, and so they figured out, you know, we were down to, you know, to visit and everything, and they knew what area we were in, so they put that together, I'm sure.
Brother, ain't you grown?
But it's just a matter. Oh, I've been growing tremendously.
Yeah, I mean, but you're a grown man, though, ain't you?
I was picked up. Oh, yes, sir. Yes, sir, I am grown.
Yeah, you got a wife, you got a family, you're a veteran, got a job, you're taking care of your home. Isn't that true?
Yes, sir.
Brother, it ain't none of their business what you're doing. It ain't none of their business.
That's right.
Don't you even let them into your business. Don't even, man, if they, I wouldn't, man, I, I just got a totally different take. My family men are dare not do nothing like that. But, you know, that's how these hypocrites are. It's other MA. Let me see. You keeping and obeying Jesus. You keeping the law, statutes, and commandments. You've been filled with the Holy Spirit. You got the power of Yah. And then these devils want to set up and attack you for being real, for being faithful, and not being a hypocrite. And I guarantee you, all them family members, they all pagans. I guarantee you they go to church on Sunday. I guarantee you that they celebrate Christmas. I guarantee you they celebrate Easter. I guarantee you the women wear makeup and they wear pants and they rebellious against their husbands. Am I on point so far?
You're right on point so far, Pastor. The only thing is it's actually my wife's family, so I don't have as much interaction, almost none, really with them. My family hasn't really posed much opposition. They just kind of, you know, hey, yeah, as long as we get to talk to y'all, you know, everything, you know, cool and this and that. But they haven't posed any opposition yet, and that's all I'll say yet, because there's no telling. Really, when you walking the straight and narrow, the straight way, there's no telling.
Let me help you out, son. Can I help you out?
Yes, sir.
Number one, your wife is not married to her family. She's married to you. And you are the head of that house. That is your wife. And what I personally would do, of course, Sister Carol, she did a long time ago. Her family started cutting the food. She said, you ain't got to worry about seeing me again. Bye. And she never contacted them. Years went by before she contacted. And I said, you know what? I said, go ahead and contact them, see how they're doing. And I gave her leave to contact them. Other than that, and you know what that did? That straightened their rear end out.
Yes, sir.
That straightened them out.
Understood.
Yes, they ain't going to have no control over my life.
That was the plan. Yes, sir. That was the plan. I just wanted to let you know that it confirmed a lot of things. And even you just saying that to me, Pastor, still it helps a lot because that's where I was leaning. But I didn't want to do anything without, you know, the Father leading me to do it just on my own will or out of anger or whatever.
I hate to interrupt, but son, you got righteous indignation. You remember this. If anybody is trying to make any type of an attack on your family, be it assault form or something like that, they are your enemies. You distance yourself from them bastards. That's what you do. Because they start calling the police on you and all this other stuff, man, they mean destruction for your family. And and they're being used by the devil.
Yes, sir.
I'd cut them off. That's what I do. They wouldn't hear from me again. And my wife family definitely wouldn't hear from me. Because you know why? That's your house.
Yes, sir. That's what I said. Yes, sir. And I ain't want to stay on too long. I know you got a lot of callers too, but I was convicted also about sending my tithes because I haven't really been sending them as much. And I got a money order and I just kind of forgot about it too. We put it in the mail, but I'm glad y'all started really talking more about the tithes because we really are being blessed by the ministry, and it's just flat out wrong not to help out, not to support. Especially, you know, when you're bringing some of your burdens and some of your demons or some of what, you know, whatever to the table. So it's only right to give to the ministry that's upholding the truth. So hallelujah. I just want to say that. And Shabbat Shalom, Pastor. We love you. We love all the saints.
Hallelujah, my brother. Y'all be encouraged, okay, my brother? You stand firm, stand strong, man. You're a strong, strong man, brother. You the head of him. You can stand against them wicked devils.
Yes, sir. I appreciate you, Pastor.
Hallelujah. You too. You and your family, I love you, man. Bless you. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
I'm going to read all you people something out there. I know you don't read the Bible. I know you don't. The most time you ever hear about the Bible read is if I'm reading it or if you heard it or somebody quoting the scripture. But I'm going to read you, all of you, the very words of Jesus himself. Do you believe Jesus? Do you believe the Bible? Do you believe the report? Because remember, man should not live by bread alone. And remember, Matthew 6:32 said, you should seek ye first the kingdom of Yah and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added to you. I'm glad Brother Mike called in. It gives me an opportunity to talk to all of you out there. Jesus said, in Matthew 10:24 that the disciple is not above his master, nor the servant above his Lord. Alright? Now look at this. And is not it is enough for the disciple that he be as his master and the servant as his Lord. And if they call the master of the house Beelzebub, how much more shall they call them of his household? Now look what he says. I'm going on down. Alright? Listen to this. Verse 34, Matthew 10. Think not that I have come to send peace on earth. I come not to send peace, but a sword. Y'all hear what Jesus said he come to do? He come to send a sword. What is that sword? Well, look what he says. For I have come to set a man at variance against his father. Yeah, Jesus Christ, you know. He come to bring division and odds between a man and his father. And a daughter against her mother. And a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. And look what it says. And a man's own foes shall be there of his own household. And then Jesus go on to say is, now, what Jesus is getting ready to say, this is very occultic to the mindset of some of you people out there. Jesus said, he that love a father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. And he that love a son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And he that taketh up not his tree or cross and follow not me is not worthy of me. So there's a lot of people just simply ain't worthy of Christ. And if they ain't worthy of Christ, they ain't worthy of you. Hallelujah. How you like that? Glory to the King. Isn't that beautiful? Now let's see how many people love the Bible. These hypocrites, they don't love the Bible. These just religious hypocrites. They devils. That's what they are. Start binding them, Brother Mike. Hallelujah. 646 Brother Mike in New York. 646 Brother Mike in New York. This is Pastor Dow. You on the Strictly Truth Radio podcast. I can help you. Y'all come on, man.
Goodbye, Pastor Dow.
Cut that thing off, brother, so I can hear you.
Shabbat shalom, Pastor Dow.
Shabbat shalom, Brother Mike.
How you doing, Pastor? I'm here with the brothers. They all want to say Shabbat shalom.
Glory to the King. Come on with it, New York.
Shabbat shalom, Shepherd's Brother Steve. Shabbat shalom, brother.
Shabbat shalom, Pastor. This is Brother Nick.
Shabbat shalom, Brother Dominic.
Shabbat shalom, Pastor. We just want to tell you we love you. We miss you. We can't wait to hug you next soon. Bless all the saints, and see you soon, Pastor. Shabbat shalom.
Hallelujah. Y'all be encouraged. Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.
That's New York. Hallelujah. All right, let's go to North Carolina, Sister Vivian. This is Pastor Dow. You're on Straight Truth Radio broadcast. How can I help you, Sister Vivian?
Shabbat shalom, Pastor Dow.
All right, Shabbat.
I just had a question.
All right, go ahead.
Concerning Zerat, or biblical leprosy, Hansen's disease.
Hold on for a second. Did you say concerning the rod or concerning which one? Biblical leprosy or rot? Which one?
Zerat. Zerat is just, yes, Zerat.
Oh, Zerat. Okay, I got you. Come on.
Okay, so I know that it gives in Exodus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy, and 1st and 2nd Kings, and in writings of Paul, it talks about leprosy, about the problem with leprosy. Well, excuse me, I know that it's not Hansen's disease because that is a malformation. We know that there's the physical realm and then there's the spiritual realm.
Correct.
So when I'm thinking of the spiritual realm, something like psoriasis, or severe eczema, could that be a physical manifestation of a spiritual problem that you need to take care of?
Yes.
Okay. Well, then I need to come to Straightway and maybe get deliverance. Because every day when I, you know, do my prayers in the morning and prayers in the evening, I always include Psalm 58 because that psalm brings tears to my eyes every day. Mm-hmm. I see my sin, and a sin is like an onion. Every time you peel it away, there's another layer. You peel that away, there's another layer. We're in a fallen world. We're fallen beings. But I know it can be overcome. I just don't know how to do it.
Yeah, it can, and then you have to understand, you have to make sure it has no generational curses as well. You know, a lot of stuff, could be something in your diet, too. I mean, there's a natural and a spiritual, you know, aspect to each one of it. You understand what I mean?
Yes. Well, I grow a lot of my food, and I don't eat anything that's not kosher.
Right.
Never. I was raised in a home where we had a kosher kitchen. So the diet I'm not as concerned with, but autoimmune diseases I am concerned with.
Gotcha.
And I think that there's a lot of things that I'm not aware of that need to be addressed.
I got you.
Okay. Well, I look forward to at Pesach.
All right.
And get deliverance.
Sounds good to me.
You send your wife my Shabbat Shalom and all the sisters there and the brothers. And thank you very much for taking my call.
Yes, ma'am. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
All right, let's go to Georgia, Brother Al. Call number 678-678. This is Pastor Dowell. You on the Straight Ridge Youth Radio broadcast. How can I help you, Brother Al?
Shabbat Shalom, Pastor. Shabbat Shalom, Yisrael.
Oh, Shabbat Brother Shalom, Emmy. Brother Emmy.
Hallelujah. I got a quick question for you, Pastor.
All right, what you got?
What is the initiative, or what is the goal point to attack spiritual warfare when you want to cause destruction, everything, when you want to send little hail, angels of destruction? What is the goal point when somebody crosses the line, says something, say something, different information?
Have you ever read the Psalms and how David prayed against his enemies? You ever read Psalms 109?
I gotta go over it, Pastor.
All right. I'll tell you what, I'll read you some of it. You ready?
Yes, sir.
Stumble start at verse 2. For the mouth of the wicked and the mouth of the deceitful are open against me. They have spoken against me with a lying tongue. They can pass me about also with words of hatred and fought against me without a cause. It sounds like David got an enemy, don't it, my brother?
Yes, sir.
For my love, they are my adversaries, but I give myself unto prayer. Uh-oh, well, we're going to see what kind of prayer he gives himself to. And they have rewarded me evil for good and hatred for my love. You know what David said next verse? Set thou a wicked man over him, and let Satan stand at his right hand. And when he shall be judged, let him be condemned. And let his prayer become sin. Let his days be few, and let another take his office. Let his children be fatherless, and his wife a widow. And let his children be continued vagabonds, and beg, and let them seek their bread out of their desolate places. Let the extortioner catch all that he hath, and let the stranger spoil his labor. Let there be none to extend mercy unto him, neither let there be any to favor his fatherless children. Let his propensity be cut off, and in the generation following, let their name be blotted out. Let the iniquity of his fathers be remembered with the Lord, and let not the sin of his mother be blotted out. Let them be before the Lord continually, that he may cut off the memory of them from the earth, because he remembered not to show mercy, but persecuted the poor and the needy man, that he might even slay the brokenhearted. As he loved cursing, so let it come unto him. As he delight in not in blessing, so let it be far from him. As he clothe himself with cursing, like as a garment, so let it come into his bowels like water, and the oil into his bones. And let it be unto him as a garment which covered him, for of the girdle wherewith he is girdled continually. Let this be the reward of my adversaries from the Lord, of them that speak evil against my soul. But do thou for me, O Yah, the Lord, for thy name's sake, because thy mercy is good. Deliver you me, for I am poor and needy, and my heart is wounded within me. I tell you what, it sounds like David knew how to take care of his enemies, didn't it?
Yes, sir.
Did that answer your question?
Yes, sir.
David cursed not only them, but the whole entire damn family. And mind you, David is a man right after Yah's own heart.
Hallelujah.
And if you got adversaries out there, Israel, that's how you pray against your adversaries. Go ahead.
Hallelujah. Yes, sir. I'm passing over to Brother Will, Pastor. You got want to say something, please?
Bless you, Brother Emmy.
Shabbat Shalom, Pastor.
Shabbat Shalom, son. Shabbat Shalom. How you doing, Brother Will?
I'm doing blessed, sir. Just want to say Shabbat Shalom. I love you. I love the family at Straightway scattered abroad. And you're continually in my prayers, as well as all the saints.
Hallelujah. Bless you, son.
All right, bless you. I got Brother Al over here.
Glory to the King.
Hey, Shabbat Shalom, Pastor.
Hey, bless you, sir. How you doing?
Favor, sir. Favor. I do have a question for you about the Kansas Redeemer, though.
Go ahead.
Let's say the man was either born and had injury and can't have seed to begin with, or if he was a eunuch or something of that sort. Does the Kinsman's Redeemer law still apply, even though the man can't have seed to begin with, even before he married his wife?
You know, that's a very good question, because we have never seen barrenness in reference to a male mentioned ever in Scripture.
Yes, sir. Because it does say that none will be barren amongst Israel.
Exactly. And, you know, the barrenness was always, you know, on the woman's side of things. I would probably say that there's something going on with a man. He's probably got a curse on himself. And he probably don't even know it, if you understand what I mean. He's got a curse on himself. Because, again, that's a good question. But, you know, there's no way that you can actually, because if this man is married to a wife, it will still be committing adultery. Because a woman is only promised to that man. It doesn't make, the Bible does not give us instruction that says if there was barrenness on the man's part, that, you know, to let the wife go to somebody else. It doesn't say that. But it does talk about the kinsman redeemer upon his death. If he dies without seed and stuff, then she has to actually get married to his brother or whoever's in line of their succession. Right.
Yes, sir. That's the part we got confused, because since we are in captivity and, you know, we are in a strange land, you know, there are curses, and that's kind of where we got stuck. Is it that you're cursed, and therefore, you know, the Kansas Redeemer law wouldn't apply or would apply? But as far as Israel itself, biblically, you know, we do understand that there was no barrenness unless there was a case of a curse or so forth.
Yes, sir.
And I got Sister Megan connected to me. She wants to say Shabbat Shalom.
All right.
Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom, Sister Megan. How you doing?
Well, I just wanted to say Shabbat Shalom to you and the saints there, and to let you know that I was thinking about you guys, and I can't wait to come back to see y'all and meet the rest of the saints that I haven't met yet.
Hey, you had a pretty good time up here your first visit to Straightway, didn't you?
Yes, sir, I did.
Well, we enjoyed you.
I told Brother Al. Well, thank you. I enjoyed being there. I told Brother Al on the way home, I said, I kind of want to go that direction. He was like, we have our land. So I was like, okay. But I didn't.
Hallelujah. Oh, yeah, you'll get plenty of time. Brother Al and him, he's usually pretty consistent coming up and visiting and stuff and being with us. So, yeah, you'll be able to get to see us, believe me, a lot.
Yes, sir. Tell Sister Carol I said hello, and I guess I will pass the phone on. I'm not really sure. Hold on 1 second.
All right, Pastor, that's all we got. Bless you, sir.
All right. Hey, give Mother Muncie our love.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, I will. She's probably already in bed.
All right, Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom, Pastor. Bless you.
Glory to the King. Good question there. Dang good question. Let's go to New York. Call number 347, Brother Jose. It's Pastor Dow. You're on the Straightway Truth Radio broadcast. How can I help you?
Shabbat Shalom, Pastor. I got a question. Is Yah still speaking to people nowadays or no?
Sure he is.
Because last day I had a dream that I think it was Yah speaking to me. I don't know. His voice sounded like the description of his voice in the Book of Revelation. And it said that his voice sounded like many thunderings.
Yeah.
And he said to me, repent and I will keep my words. What does that truly mean?
He said that again.
Repent and I will keep my words.
Yeah, in other words, meet my conditions and then I will actually perform the terms of this contract. You remember when Israel, when they received the commandments and everything, and they said, yeah, all this we'll do, we agree, we will do. But did they do it? No, they didn't do it because they ended up being cursed. And remember, Hebrews 1 and 2 says, he hath in these last days spoken unto us by his Son, whom he hath appointed heir of all things, by whom also he made the worlds. Go ahead.
My question is, how do you detect the spirit of gluttony?
How you detect the spirit of gluttony?
Yeah.
Look in the mirror.
That's it?
Yeah. If you fat, you're a glutton.
And how you break it?
Put a knife to your throat. Now, don't do that literally now. Don't sit up there and say, pass down telling people to kill themselves and carry on. Brother, what you do is you change your diet. Learn how to eat right. Repent. Turn from your wicked way. Remember, your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit. You do know that, right? Your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit. You know that, right?
Yeah.
Y'all dwelling in there, man. And so, and if you big and fat, what are you going to do? You're going to close them in by having fat all around you and stuff, and y'all can't even breathe in the temple?
I'm sorry, Pastor. I was speaking to my family.
Well, you on the phone. Talk to me. Then you can talk to them when you get off the phone.
That's all I really got to say right now. But hold on, wait. Before you go, I was having another experience, I think it was 2 months ago. I was sleeping, and I heard wicked spirits actually speaking to me, and they were telling me what they were doing to me, and how wicked I was, and it was scary. And I also heard when I said Yah's name in the spirit, I heard behind me phrases and stuff like that. It was beautiful and it was scary too. Oh man.
Well, that's a fearful thing with Yah, that's for sure.
That's all I got to say for now.
All right, my brother.
Shabbat Shalom, Pastor.
Shabbat Shalom. Hey, let me tell y'all something. Many times we hear things in our spirit. You have to be able to discern if it's Yah or the devil. The only thing that the devil is looking for, let's say if you got something negative coming up on you and you got a spirit talking to you and is trying to depress you and drag you down, the only thing the devil's trying to get you to do is agree with it. He's looking for your agreement so he can gain power and access and control. That's why you have to become very proactive in casting down these wicked thoughts and these imaginations so you don't give place to the devil. You know, this walk is not a passive walk. Not at all. It's a war. Let's go to New York. New York, 347. Man, we've had a lot of calls from New York. This is Pastor Dow. You're on the Straight Truth Radio broadcast. I can help you.
Hello, Pastor.
New York going once.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Oh, Shabbat Shalom, Pastor Donald. This is David.
Hey, David.
I met you over in Fairfield at a debate with Roberts.
Okay. Good to meet you.
And I was... Nice meeting you as well. I was just calling in to say Shabbat Shalom, making myself known, and thank you for doing what you do. Thank you for being a Jeremiah 3:15.
Well, you're welcome. Continue to keep me lifted up in prayer.
I will do. Will do. Also, my wife wanted to ask you a question as well.
Okay.
Hold on. One second.
Shabbat Shalom, Pastor Dow.
Shabbat.
Sister Joan.
Sister Joan.
Junalyn, Pastor Dow, sorry.
Okay, go ahead.
Yes, Pastor Dow. Me and my husband, we've been going to the gym. I just wanted to ask you, I just wanted to know what's the proper dressing for as a sister, especially like in the public, in the gym. Like, I'm not quite sure what exactly to dress.
Well, our sisters don't go to any gym out there in the public. We have our own. We have our own gym on the land, and of course, you know, we live a set apart life. I would not recommend unless your husband, like other men, looking at the form of your figure and stuff like that. I wouldn't recommend you going to the gym. I wouldn't recommend you wearing no tight pants, tight leotards, or whatever you want to call it. And being around all those Gentiles so they can gawk all over you and everything, I would be set apart and holy, sister. And I would do a lot of exercise I could do at home, maybe buy some weights or something like that, but I would live set apart. I wouldn't dare, as a sister, put my body on display for nobody else when it should only be on display for my husband.
Yes, sir. Well, thank you, sir. Now, thank you for that information, and I just want to let you know that thank you so much for all your works and Sister Ashley as well and her blog talk. It's been really very helpful, sir.
Hey, hallelujah. I ask you a question to get you to think, okay?
Yes, sir.
All right, if you came here to Shabbat service, all right, let's say you came to the tabernacle at Shabbat service, okay?
Yes, sir.
I mean, because sometimes men walk around in that gym with no shirts on. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Yep. And they wearing shorts and they showing their little thing and everything, ain't they?
Yes, sir. Definitely, yes.
All right. So would it be all right if Pastor Dow come in here Shabbat morning and I just walk right on down the aisle in my underwear or I got my gym shorts on and I just be butt naked and just go up there and start preaching in the pulpit? Is that all right with you?
No, sir, not at all.
Well, then good. I'm glad you said that, because don't be a hypocrite, because it ain't all right for you to be wearing pants. It ain't all right for you to be going out there showing your figure to every man out there to be gawking over either.
Yes, sir. What about like wearing a loose sweatpants and a loose like a beat up shirt, like my husband's shirts or something like that? After that, would that be just fine?
I think you're missing the point here, sister. You shouldn't even want to be in an environment where there are men walking around halfway damn naked.
Okay.
You have to be holy.
Yes,
you have
sir.
To be set apart. Are you following me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You don't want to put temptation there in front of you. Are you listening?
Yes, sir. Definitely.
You don't want to put temptation. You don't put temptation in front of you. And I know that the devil will be challenging your mind. Hey, look over there and look at that. Look at that right there. Look at that. Now, you don't want that, man. And then you go home and have to fantasize and have to cast down thoughts and imaginations. And then your husband up there doing the same thing. He up there watching them women around with all that ass hanging out and chest hanging out all over the damn place. And he has to go and fight temptations and stuff because he's seeing all that flesh running around. I mean, I don't want a man. Hey, I'm a fine specimen, man. I don't want these sisters to be falling out all over the place and can't even keep their mind on the message because they're looking at Pastor Dow coming here in his birthday suit and just covered up with a diaper.
Yes, sir. Well, thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for the information that you provided me. And I just wanted to, my husband wanted to say another thing also, Pastor Dow.
Okay.
Sorry for keeping you so long.
Go ahead, my brother.
Hey, Pastor. We just wanted to get the green light from you that we can come over to Passover and fellowship.
Come on down. Just call the dining hall. Let them know you got approval from Pastor Dow on Blog Talk Radio. Leave your name, your number, contact information, the dates that you're coming, and the dates that you're leaving, okay?
That's good news. That's really good news.
Because we got a lot of people up there in New York that's going to be coming down.
Yeah, we've been fellowshipping with Elder Felix, Brother Steve, and Brother Nick.
Hey, brother, you got to get this point over to yourself and your wife. You getting this, right?
Yes, I am. I heard everything loud and clear.
You don't want me to come up there and preach up there to y'all, and then I come in and I step out in my Fruit of Looms only.
I hear you.
All right, hallelujah. Y'all get that right, Israel. We got to be holy. We got to be set apart, all right?
Yes, sir.
Looking forward to seeing y'all.
Looking forward to seeing you as well.
All right.
Thank you, and Shabbat Shalom.
Hey, what's your name again, brother?
Hello.
David.
All right, David. Looking forward to seeing y'all, man. Bless y'all.
Bless you as well.
Hallelujah.
Shalom.
I know. I mean, sometimes I got to go that route just in order to get the point over. Because if y'all say that it's okay for a woman to be going to gym with some spandex on and showing a form figure, and y'all 100% convicted, I'm going to walk in this tabernacle tomorrow butt naked. And I'm going to walk up into that pulpit and I'm going to preach and nobody better not say a damn thing about it either. And if I can't do that, then y'all can't dress the way y'all doing. Hallelujah. Florida, 407 is Pastor Dow. You're on the Straight With Truth radio broadcast. I can help you. Florida going once, Florida going twice, Florida three times, yeah. California, call number 714-714, it's Pastor Dow, you're on the Straight With Truth radio broadcast, I can help you.
Florida going twice, Florida three times, yeah. California, call number 714-714, it's Pastor Dow, you're on the
Straight With Truth radio
broadcast, I can help you.
All right.
Yes.
Let's go to Texas. Call number 915. Brother Daniel, it's Pastor Dow. You're on the Straight With Truth radio broadcast. I can help you there, Brother Daniel.
Hey, Pastor Dow.
Yes, sir.
Let you know that you're my sergeant major.
Sergeant major, huh? Sergeant Major Dow, huh?
Well, I just want to let you know that I'm thinking about you, and I'm praying for the ministry, and that's about it.
All right, my brother, I need it. Keep me lifted up. All right.
Roger that.
All right. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
All right. Glory to the King. Hey, I bless y'all. Each and every last one of you, sweet, precious, strong, victorious, mighty, overcoming name, our soon coming King, Yahshua Mashiach, Jesus Christ. Looking forward to hearing from y'all all day tomorrow. Remember, www.online-church.org. We may not be there, but we will be, hopefully, they brought saying out this message. We're going to try to broadcast on YouTube. We'll keep y'all posted. The default channel is going back to online on online-church.org. So if we disconnect from YouTube because we're having hiccups or something like that, we'll go to online-church.org. All right? Bless y'all. The King coming. Shabbat Shalom. See y'all tomorrow, 11 a.m. Central Standard Time. Be there.
look at him looking.